There are so many vibe coding tools out there that it can be hard to know which one to use. Replit is one of the best that I've come across, and it's great for people regardless of their technical background. You don't need any coding experience to build an app with Replit. In this video, you're going to learn how to build a production-ready app using Replit. From start to finish, we are going to build a real social web app. You're gonna see how powerful Replit is and how quick it is to build something that people can actually use. And you're gonna see how easy it is to turn your ideas into reality. Thank you to Replit for sponsoring this video. Click the link in the description to start using Replit for free and build alongside me in this video. There's a lot to cover, so let's jump in. The prompt I'm using is make a web app that helps golfers find new friends to play with, create profiles with golf goals and preferences, match users based on location and skill level, and include a messaging system. Design it with vibrant colors and engaging social interface. And then under the app type, we're going to do a modern web app. And then I'm going to click the improve prompt button to make this prompt even better. Now, this is a pretty complicated app that we're going to build. And I think this is really going to show you the power of Replit and what's possible with Replit and how easily you can build apps with it. So what's nice about its improved prompt feature is it breaks it down into core features, visual reference, and a style guide. So pretty cool. Visual reference, Bumble, BFF, and Strava's social feature. It gave a color, style guide, design inspiration, design guide, and then the core features, user profile, location, and skill-based matching, in-app messaging, and search and filter functionality to find golfers in your area. So let's go ahead and start the chat. So this is what creates the chat in Replit, and it goes into this planning phase. So in the planning phase, Replit is going to give you a list of the features that it wants to build. It's going to also create like a design inspiration. So it's going to code up a very basic front end for the beginning. And then you get to decide whether you want to stick with that plan or make any changes. Okay, so Replit has completed its plan. On the left side, we have the initial features. So we have the initial version with user profile, location-based matching, skill filtering, in-app messaging, discovery, profile browsing with swipe, and match notification and connection request. So quite a lot of features for that initial version. I think that all sounds good. And then it has some like later features that it can do later, such as real-time chat, advanced matching algorithm, golf course integration, things like that. I like the feature set. And then what I really like about Replit is on the right side, we have a visual preview. So it mocked up this entire front end of the website. And I'm wondering, I think it might even have generated this image and it might be generating images for the mockup. And I really like what it created here. It's really good, like this indication of an app. It even built out like this mockup of what the app looks like, conversations, creating a golf profile, why you should do it. So I really do actually like this preview. So what you can do is keep chatting and review the plan and tweak it. But I'm going to go ahead and approve it and start. So at this point, what Replit is going to do is on the left side, the agent is going to start working and building out those initial features. And on the right side, the preview is going to update once we have the next version to see. And just jumping in here on the left side, we can see all of the work that's happening. It's creating the messages page, discover page, profile page, home page. It's building out components. It's building out a lot of things that are going to go into the app. So the first initial build usually takes the longest, and then future features will be built out a little bit more quickly. We can also see on the left side that it is creating an object storage bucket, which I assume is for profile pictures. And it's also setting up the database. So that's something with Replit. The database is integrated, although it uses Neon as the database. It's not going to be like proprietary to Replit. You're not stuck in the Replit ecosystem if you want to take your code and your database later on, but it's all going to be integrated and easily set up here inside of Replit. And then here real quick, something that is also cool, even though there is an error, that's not ideal. But what Replit is able to do, the agent is able to debug automatically. And that's what makes the Replit agent so powerful. All right, let's see what the agent is telling us. It says it built out the social platform with the golf theme design, the hero section, showcasing the platform's value, discover page, profile creation, real-time messaging, mobile responsive design. It says, how does the overall design and user experience feel? Are the golf-themed colors appealing, and does the app seem intuitive? So I actually do really like the design. The one question that I have is basically, do people need to log in? Like, it looks like it has this create profile, but I don't know that I logged in yet. I'm going to say the design looks good, but do we need user authentication so users can log in before creating a profile and accessing features like messaging? So it says we're right. It needs to implement Replit Auth using the provided blueprint to add user login, registration, and protected routes. So this is another thing that's nice about Replit is Auth authentication, meaning how users sign in and sign up, is all connected into the Replit ecosystem. So they have that pre-built, so you don't have to worry about setting that up yourself, which is really nice. And just to quickly explain to you what's happening on the agent side, it's going through step by step all of the things that it needs to do. So it's creating database storage to replace the in-memory storage that's like the browser-based storage with proper database storage. Then it's replacing the entire storage class implementation properly. It is then updating the routes to integrate with Replit Auth and protecting the user-related API routes with authentication, meaning that users should only be able to go to where they are supposed to be able to go based on them being logged in. So now Replit is telling us it has completed the authentication system. It has database integration, protected API routes, landing page for new users, which I see here, which is great that it knew to do that on its own. User profile dropdown and logout option, and loading states during authentication checks. Let's test this out. It's asking me how the authentication flow feels. So why don't we go, and when you're testing authentication in Replit, it's good to open it in a new tab. And then I'm just going to go ahead and click get started. And I assume this is going to take me to basically a Replit login. So I'm just going to click allow. And because I'm already logged into Replit, it's just had that allow. Otherwise, it would basically, if I was in incognito or any other user, it would prompt you to either log in with like Google or other auths, or you could just use email and password to create an account. So here I'm logged in now, and I can see what it looks like for a logged in user. Like it said, it has the dropdown for profile and logout. And then from here, once you're logged in, users can go ahead, create a profile, enter in information about themselves. Then once obviously more users are on the app, right now it's just me, so it's a little hard to test. I could ask Replit probably to add fake users to see what it looks like. But here is where you would be able to discover. You can even enable your location, which is pretty cool, and then it'll use your location from your browser. We have messages to actually chat with people. And then all the basic functionality that we wanted is here in the app. So Replit successfully built out an app with a logged out state. So for users who aren't logged in yet, there's a landing page. And then once you log in, there's the profile, messages, and discover pages all created. And it did this basically in two prompts. So if we go back to Replit, basically we had our initial prompt, then we had another prompt asking for authentication. And then here we are. That was basically it. Really impressive what Replit was able to do. So I'm going to say I like the design and the features. And let's see what Replit responds with when you just give it that response. So that's pretty cool. It has access to the logs. So it knows that I successfully logged in and the authentication is working. And it sees that I've been exploring the app, the discover feature is working, and you've uploaded a profile picture. I uploaded a picture before when I was testing that out, but I didn't record that in this video. So the other thing that's cool is it sees that there's API calls failing, basically in the logs. I guess it saw when I was going around the app, certain things were failing. Now it's fixing that. And then now it's basically just summarizing where we are, creating a checkpoint. These checkpoints in Replit are also really helpful because you can always roll back to this. If we build out something in the future and it's not working, we can always go back. And now it's asking, is there any particular aspect of authentication or overall app experience you'd like me to enhance further? So there's, of course, so much more that we could build into this app, but I want to stop now because I think that this has given you a really good idea of what's possible with Replit and how powerful Replit is. We started from just a prompt. We optimized that prompt. We built out an entire front end and back end with a database and user authentication for a social app, and we did it in about 10 minutes. So you can just imagine how much further we can get if we spent more time building this out and refining it and tweaking it for our specific use case. The last thing I just want to cover quickly is Replit has deployment built in as well. So if we go to the more tools here and we go to deployment, all you have to do is click set up your deployment. It deploys it, and then you'll have a URL that anyone can access on the internet. And it scales up really well because it's autoscale. So this is really great for production ready apps that really could be used even in enterprise level apps. The other thing to be aware of with Replit is they have a really cool security scanner. So if you click that, it's going to scan for vulnerabilities. And this is something that's a hot topic with vibe coding. But really, there's no reason that vibe coding has to not be secure. It's just a matter of running the appropriate checks and making sure that everything is set up properly, especially with the database, and everything is done in the correct way. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Leave a comment below to let me know what you think and if Replit is something that you could see yourself building with. And click the link in the description to go to Replit and start building for free. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content just like this, and we'll see you in the next video.